Here's something I knew I had to get when I saw it. Now, as maybe you can tell by the condition of the packaging, this was not a new item when I bought it. I actually got it at Goodwill for $9.99. But it is the smartphone magnifier. It says double your screen. And it is styled to look like a wood grain CRT television. And you stick your smartphone in the back and it magnifies the image. More wood grain on the sides. And on the back it has more details here. It says, a lo-fi, hands-free way to watch mobile movies at twice the original size. Load your phone into the retro TV-styled viewer to enjoy your smartphone content on an 8-inch screen. Comes assembled. It fits phones up to 16 centimeters or 6.3 inches long by 8 centimeters or 3.1 inches wide. Well, I have my $39 LG smartphone here. Other brands are available, and I'll have to measure it to see if it fits. Okay, we are definitely under 6.3 inches long, and we are under 3.1 inches wide, so it should fit. The brand on this is Lucky's of London, based in the UK. Says manufactured in PRC, which is China. Says warning, this is not a toy. Not suitable for children under 14. I don't understand why a 13-year-old would not be able to use this device. It looks fairly simple. It also has a warning about exposing the lens to direct sunlight. It says there's a risk of heat damage because of the magnifier in there. Looks like this was sold by Francesca's. It's crossed out, but it looks like it said $30. Can't quite read it, but I think it says $30. Well, I didn't spend $30 on it, but we'll see if it's worth $10. This tape that Goodwill puts on the boxes is both good and bad. It's good because it helps prevent the items inside from getting lost or broken or stolen, but it's bad because it makes it difficult to verify in the store whether or not it actually includes all the parts in the box. But it should be open now. That looks like the back with fake input jacks for video 1 and video 2 composite, S video and antenna input. And it has a fake manufacturing information plate. It says it's model LL-209. Lucky's Vision TV receiver. Claims it runs on AC 60 Hz, 220 volts, 98 watts maximum. Well, obviously it doesn't run on anything, it's just a magnifier. It has fake cooling vents in the back. And okay, that's how it works. It pulls out, and then you put your smartphone in there and this pocket here. There you can see the front. Unfortunately, the side of the box was actually the side of the unit itself, so that left that tape on the side, which may or may not be able to be removed without damaging the fake wood grain styling. On the front, we have fake controls for color, sound, and channel, aux and microphone inputs, and a little hole here, I guess, for the sound to come out of your smartphone. Nothing on the bottom except some fake rubber feet. Surprisingly, they didn't try to put fake rabbit ears on the top. It just has this warning sticker. So, I don't know how well this is going to work. There's my smartphone. I guess it just slides in the back. And we're supposed to be able to view it from the front. So let me try to get a video playing here. Oh, this backing is kind of sticky, so I guess you're supposed to put your phone in the middle of it. Okay, I have my phone installed in the backer. And since LGR often talks about CRTs and wood grain, I thought it would be appropriate to test it out with one of his videos. At the end of his review of this 17-inch ViewSonic CRT monitor.
From a moment ago, it looks amazing in person because, you know, higher frame rates are nicer on the eyes, but looks like garbage in a camera, and that's just how that works because the shadows.
I agree, it looks like garbage because you can see even with the magnification, it doesn't fill up nearly the whole screen. And it sort of just fell off the backer there.
I don't know about you, but I don't really like flossing my teeth. Although I know it's something useful.
Looking for a new 4 or 5 door car, around 1.6 liters and under 6,000 pounds.
So several other problems besides the image being much smaller than the size of the screen. One you just saw, the phone keeps falling off that sticky backer. The copyright on the box says 2016, so it's only 2 years old, so it's not like it's been sitting for 10 years and lost all its stickiness. So that probably would have been a problem even if it was new. And also the sound gets very muffled because it's inside a box, even with these holes in the front. I had my phone's volume turned all the way up and it was still just barely audible. And also the viewing angle is rubbish. As soon as you turn it a little bit to the side, it just completely distorts and disappears. So you have to be facing head on in order to see it. So it's really only a one person at a time kind of thing. Otherwise, you're just not going to be able to see it. I noticed they have some instructions on the inside of the box here. It says, use landscape content, disable auto brightness, set your brightness to 100% and your volume to 100%. Well, I followed all those guidelines and it still looked terrible. And then they mention here, rinse gel under running water to renew its, incorrectly spelled with an apostrophe, stickiness. Well, I don't know how much that would have helped. It says view from front, which you have to do, otherwise you won't see it, and enjoy. So maybe if I actually followed that guideline to rinse that gel, maybe then the phone would actually stay stuck to it. But even then, for all the other reasons I mentioned, this is really just a gimmick. Doesn't really work that well. Well, at least I was able to peel off that sticky tape without damaging the fake wood grain finish. But I can see why somebody ended up donating this to Goodwill, especially if they originally paid $30 for this. It's a neat idea, but flawed execution. So that's the Lucky's Vision smartphone magnifier designed to look like a wood grain CRT television. Maybe with some better optics in there to magnify the image and an actual speaker you plug into your smartphone instead of just holes punched in the front. Maybe it wouldn't be so bad, but as it is, I can't recommend this product. Just doesn't work that well.
Bloody awful.
Look at where it says ice cold Coca-Cola. Now look what happens afterwards. 35 degrees. Ice can't freeze at 35 degrees, hon.
But can you explain the frost forming on the inside of the display?
I believe that is an artificial frost to make it seem like this is ice cold. When in fact, it's only 35 degrees. It was 36 degrees earlier, but now it's 35.